And welcome to today's glute workout. We are going to do lots of bridge variations. It's only going to be 7 minutes. It's going to be wonderful and awesome. So you can have weights, you can have no weights. If you are also pregnant, but you are kind of done with laying on your back, you can use a Swiss ball or a step or something where you're not lying on your back is up and elevated on there. That in itself is going to add challenge. So you probably don't need weights if you're doing it raised. But yeah, I'll add a little clip at the end where I show the raised versions just so you can see them. So if you want to see those, scroll to the end real fast and then come back and do this along with us. I'm going to lay on my back because I'm so good with it. So yeah, I'm going to use weights. And yeah, you don't need weights though if you don't want them. So lots of different variations you can take here. Weighted, unweighted, elevated. Yeah, let's do it guys. I'm going to show you each one really quickly. And then we're gonna go ahead and get started. So we are going to start with a bridge march. This may be the only one that I do not use my weights on, mainly because being pregnant, you have to be more concerned with where you're placing your weights. And it's not comfortable for me to have them while marching. So if you are, you'll just hold your weights the same place that you're gonna see me hold them every other bridge variation. So for the march, abs engaged, glutes engaged, and we are marching right here. We really want those glutes squeezing to hold us up the entire time. And we want to make sure we are breathing. All right, so there's your bridge march. If you've already got your weights, beautiful. If not, that's okay too. We're gonna go into a close bridge next. So feet are a little bit closer than hip width here. And yeah, that's all you gotta do. Still stay in something that's comfortable for you, but just not your normal bridge, a little bit closer together. They don't have to be super touching or anything like that. So here we go. We are just going to squeeze up through those glutes right here. You don't want to do a big arch in your low back like that. You're just gonna be squeezing up the glutes so that your body is making a nice line here. All right, like that. Then we are going to do our wide bridge. So knees and toes point the same direction, similar to how you would set up for a sumo squat. Your feet are gonna point out a little bit here. They're gonna be outside of your mat a bit, and we are going to lift up and squeeze the same way we do all those other bridges, just like that. All right, and then we're gonna come back in for our regular bridge, but we are going to do a hold, all right? So we are going to bridge hold right here. We're gonna really be squeezing the glutes. We're gonna keep those weights on if you're using them, and you're just gonna hold for the entire 30 second interval, all right? It's gonna be wonderful. So we will start with that bridge march, and we're gonna go ahead and get started. Again, if you need to see the variations where you're elevated off the ground, scroll to the end real quick, or check my Sugar Six Pack Mom's Instagram. It's gonna be there as well, all right? So here we go. Once I start this, we have 3 seconds and we're gonna go into that bridge march. And yeah, we're gonna go ahead and get started. It's only 7 minutes, let's crush it. See, there's really no good way for me to see this timer. Actually, I can probably just put it on this wall. So it's elevated. All right, guys, everybody ready? 3, 2, 1, lift, and we are marching. So what you want to keep in mind with the bridge is it is all about your glutes. Your abs are engaged as well. You don't want to be dumping into that low back. So don't arch your lower back to try and get extra height in that bridge. That is not necessary. As long as you're feeling it in the glutes, you're engaging your abs, you're doing great. You're doing wonderful. So keep breathing, keep working. And we're going to transition. So I'm gonna grab my weights and we're gonna do that close bridge and go. So these are quick switches here. We're not taking a lot of rest. We're just working straight through, using those glutes to power through the intervals. So keep going, guys. You're crushing it. Squeeze the glutes. Breathe for 5. You're doing amazing. I hope you're already starting to feel the burn and rest. So we're gonna wide stance and go. So Get that wide bridge going, guys. Really squeeze at the top. Get a nice little bridge. Breathe. Use the glutes. Lift and lower. Nice consistent pace here. We're gonna hold after this rest. And we're gonna switch our feet. Regular bridge stance, so right outside your hips and lift. And we're just holding right here. Hold in that beautiful lifted bridge position. You've got this, guys. You're doing beautiful work. We got 15 seconds left in the hold. Isn't it funny how a hold will feel so much longer than when you're moving? You're crushing it. 5 seconds to the end of round one. And rest. All right, so we're going back to that bridge march. Let's go. And lift and march right here. So this should feel extra good now that we just did that hold and all those other intervals. But keep working. You're doing great. We're already in round two and we're only doing three. So remember that. You've only got three chances at all these moves to really get everything you can out of them. It's an opportunity to get those glutes working. 2, 1. All right, we're doing that close bridge next. Set it up and go. Close bridge right here. So your feet are set up right inside or right at your hips. Closer than that normal glute bridge where they're slightly outside. Or right at the outer side part of your hip. And keep moving. By now, they should be feeling it. We are crushing through this workout. Rest. By rest, I mean switch to your wide stance. And go. Wide bridge. We're flying through this workout, guys. You're destroying it. You're doing great things for those glutes. So keep working them. We're going into that hold next. Make sure you're really conscious and aware and still using your glutes and not arching your back for extra height. 2, 1. All right, we're going to that normal stance and lift and hold. Here we go, guys. A nice little lift and hold. Keep breathing. Keep working. It feels funny to say working when you're just holding, but it is work. You can feel it in them glutes. Almost done here. We have 6 seconds. Keep going. You've got this. 2, 1. Awesome job. All right. We're going back to that march, so let's do it. Lift and march. We're in the final round, guys. You've destroyed this. You've done amazing things. Now it's just time to finish it out. Hopefully your glutes are nice and on fire by this round, pushing through. If they aren't, you need to really make sure you're engaging them and really make sure you're challenging them. So if you're not using a weight, maybe add a weight next time. 2, 1, and rest. All right, we're going to that close bridge. Last time, guys, go. Last time for everything we're doing. That means crush it. crush it. Keep going. Really focus on those glutes. Use them. We got 10 seconds left here. Keep going. Keep working. 3, 2, rest. All right, wide bridge next. Doing awesome things. Lift and go. Keep on going. You are so close to being done. We've got less than a minute. So if those glutes are on fire, just enjoy it. Enjoy the last few seconds of burn.
You can do it. You can. Three, two, and all right, we're going into that hold, and that is it. Lift. Let's go. This is the end. You can do it. You've got this. You're destroying this workout. Think of all the benefits. 15 seconds. Oh, my glutes are on fire. Keep going though, guys. And five, three, two, rest. Oh, great job. Who knew 7 minutes could hit you so hard? All right, guys. Thank you so much for joining me. I definitely enjoyed it. It's nice and quick, and you can really feel it, which is always good. So remember, guys, subscribe and like and all those wonderful things so I can keep sharing workouts and vlogs, and definitely leave me what you'd like to see below, because I like to add stuff that you guys actually want to see. So yeah, great job. This works great as a little glute burnout after your lower body day or total body day or whatever. Or, you know, if you've only got 7 minutes and this is all you could do, that's great too. So I will be doing it with my total body day. I did it beforehand. So let's hope that I can still power through some of those glute using moves there. And yeah, congratulations. You crushed it again. Thanks for being here, and I will see you next time.